This is 88.5 WXPN Philadelphia. Member-supported radio from the University of Pennsylvania.
Public radio.
Oh, I'd be sunk without it.
If it wasn't for public radio, stations like XPN and things like NPR, nobody would even know. I mean, I wouldn't be able to do what I do at all.
Without public radio, I have no career.
That's kind of the great thing about public radio is that it gives exposure to people outside the mainstream.
And World Cafe allows artists like myself and other artists to have a voice.
I think it's absolutely crucial today that we continue to support XPN and community-based radio. As far as public radio stations go, XPN is a flagship. If America were to lose this station, you know, it would be a very scary day. So the more we can support it, the better it is for everyone.
XPN is just a treasure in Philadelphia. It's one of the reasons why people want to live here. It's one of the reasons why people stay here. It just makes life in Philadelphia better.
It's bigger than music. And when you look at the whole arts and culture of the city of Philadelphia, XPN is woven right in there with it.
We've always been looked to by an ever larger public because now we have an impact all over the world through our website and certainly through our national show, The World Cafe.
World Cafe, because it was sort of like a traveling version of XPN, created sort of a whistle-stop touring pattern because anywhere in the United States that the show was syndicated, there was an audience.
It's great to know that you have these sort of islands of friendship, you know, in the in the country that you can sort of depend on, and XPN is very much a place like that.
Public radio provides something to the community which is not provided by commercial stations. It provides new artists with an opportunity to grow and for their audiences to grow. It provides a medium by which people can listen to artists who are not found other places.
I got your letter.
One of the resources we've had in the past has been the artists. They've been willing to give of their time and their resources to help XPN continue. Times are tough for artists, and they are going to come to rely on us to help them more.
If it wasn't for public radio, I mean, we wouldn't have much versatility in music. We'd have some pretty ho-hum radio.
XPN has been able to grow significantly over the last 5 years because of individual support, member support, and business support. Moving forward, we're going to need even more support because the cost of reaching people on multi-platforms continues to increase, and that's just the reality of the world.
Beyond the horizon. We're all seeing what's happening. The music industry is continuing to consolidate. The list of artists that get on the radio are getting shorter and shorter. XPN is becoming more and more important to these artists, to the audience, and to our entire culture. Meanwhile, the whole technology for delivery is changing. College students don't even own a radio. They're increasingly listening to music on their iPods, on their laptops, and now even their cell phones. Car radios are going to be able to access the internet in just a couple of years. We're determined to make XPN and the artists we play available wherever you listen. However, we can't do that without increased support, and that's why we've set up a three-fund targeted campaign for the future.
You know, I've gotten the sense from the very first times I visited the station that this was something special. back in the, even in the old studio where you'd have to climb up four flights of stairs. And now, of course, this state-of-the-art modern facility, and it's, you know, XPN deserves it, man. If any station in the country is going to get bigger and better, I hope it's this one.
I love the sound of breaking bread. The building fund's going to be used to meet our most pressing need, finishing the building. The great thing is we have the space back there to accommodate our growth. 3,500 square feet of expansion space right behind the mural wall. This will accommodate the growth of our program department, giving them the much needed space, both office and recording, to do what they do best, interact with artists and create great programming.
I like your last few albums. Beautiful woman, so sexy. Don't shake it down.
One of the challenges of working here is that we're always looking for ways to do more, to be more effective, and to grow in new directions.
Because of our commitment to do more programming, more online content, and more community outreach, there's a great demand on our space and our time. You could say we outgrew this space as soon as we moved into this building.
The building is a tangible place, and it's filled with all this equipment, but the creativity and what goes on here is ongoing. And I'm really not sure what the tools are going to be that we're going to need later on. But I do know that in order to be able to have those tools, we need to keep the level of support we've had with XPN beyond our day-to-day, into the future, looking at the things that we don't even know that we're going to need.
The second fund, the Technology and Strategic Investment Fund, is going to give us the flexibility to anticipate and react to changing circumstances in the media content delivery world. We'll also need to be able to pursue growth opportunities that make sense, whether it's geographic expansion to grow our member and service base, or production of new digital music channels.
We're living in a multi-platform environment. The sudden, significant increase in people going different places, going to different platforms for their content, it was essentially important that we needed to meet them there.
When we moved into this building about 5 years ago, we took a huge leap forward in technology, but 5 years is a long time in the digital age. Well, I'm actually starting to get files in from facilities that basically we can't handle. I actually have to take them home to convert the files.
So there's things that we'd like to do here at XPN to keep current, things like upgrading our audio quality of our web streams, adding an embedded video and audio player to the website, and video in general, being able to shoot and archive things like World Cafe performances, our Free at Noon concerts, and to be able to present that in a way that would be very beneficial to our listeners.
The third fund, the Programming and Community Engagement Fund, is at the heart of what we like to do most at XPN, create and produce great programming, and connect with the audience through arts, culture, and always music. One of the most important connections is our support and nurturing of local artists.
There are so many things that these artists need to do, but they need that stepping stone. And I really feel that it's important to have an XPN to be able to support them, encourage them, and when you have membership that gets behind them, it takes them to another level.
So steal the show and do your best to cover the tracks that I have left.
XPN breaks artists. They really have a tremendous staff with the most amazing ear for something that emerges and is unique, and they have a pulse on their audience, and their audience trusts who they're pointing out and they know to pay attention.
If it wasn't for XPN, I don't know if anybody would know who I am. It is so important to support a station like XPN because they play everybody's stuff.
We've always been seen as curators, as tastemakers, as the people who went through thousands of CDs and found the best stuff to play, or the music that our members wanted to hear.
Hop-ty-dop-ty's out on the wall, hop
Public radio, a place like WXPN, these DJs put together playlists from their heart.
One of the roles that Kids Corner plays for the artist is that I can point my audience, tomorrow's audience, to that.
Our community outreach effort puts XPN on the ground in places where I think we can really make a difference. Our partnership with the MUA Arts Program allows us to connect with the community in a different way. Musicians on Call is a program where we bring live music to the bedsides of patients who are too sick to go out and listen to music.
Most of the patients are cancer patients, they're long-term care patients, and they're going through some rough times. The music really touches the person's soul.
Maybe the sun will shine today.
I think XPN should be considered one of the major cultural institutions in the city, and therefore people who are giving to a lot of the other causes, worthy causes, should also be giving to XPN at the same levels.
XPN is one of those places where you want to be a member and you want to belong and you want to support it. And I want my children to be able to enjoy this for lots of years. So it's an investment in today, it's an investment in the future.
To me, when you think about charitable giving and providing time and treasure to organizations, it's tough to find anything that I'm more passionate about than XPN.
I think it's pretty clear that by now we have a track record as a radio station in terms of anticipating things, moving the station forward. And I think one of the things that we need from you is the wherewithal to do that. Just as you responded so amazingly to the fund to put this building up, to build this World Cafe studio. It's a little different now because we are looking at something that's intangible but equally necessary.
It's time. It's time. How many people were they running from? How many people never saw it coming? How many people never heard the cry?
To be able to say and hear ideas that you're not going to hear anywhere else, to be able to listen to music that you're not going to hear anywhere else, and to know that every time you support it by listening, or every time you support it by donating, that you are part of that, you know, energy that is keeping, you know, free speech and freedom of music and information alive.
And people out there should really, you should remember that the forums and the places where you can find your music and your art, they're shrinking in a lot of ways. And the only way to stop them from shrinking is to support them. Please support public radio, support public television, support public art anywhere, please.
This is 88.5 WXPN Philadelphia, 88.7 WXPH Middletown, York and Lancaster, 90.5 WKHS Wharton, Baltimore, 99.7 Harrisburg, 104.9 in the Lehigh Valley, and worldwide at xpn.org. Member-supported radio from the University of Pennsylvania.